Greetings and welcome, aloha, to the Kamuela Philharmonic. My name is Brian Dollinger. I'm the artistic director and conductor of the Philharmonic. We're so very excited you are joining us today for a musical journey. Today we have two amazing young musicians performing for you. They've practiced and competed in our annual concerto competition for student musicians, and they won. We'll meet them later and find out a little more about them, but let's start with our first performance. Here is Crystal Fiera performing the first movement from Felix Mendelssohn's First Piano Concerto in G minor.
Thank you.
Norwegian composer Edvard Grieg has quite a collection of incredible works. His Peer Gynt suite has some of the most recognizable music in the repertoire. But not to be outdone, his piano concerto in A minor is one of the utmost famous opening few measures in a piano repertoire. Here, Amy Okagawa will perform this very iconic first movement from Grieg's piano concerto.
Thank you.
Let's march to the zoo, not one you can view, but one that you see with your ear. No picture or text to tell you what's next. Use only the sounds that you hear. The animals there, familiar and rare, will pass in review one by one. So please take your seat, and you'll hear a lion greet you with that. The concert's begun.
Pullets, capons, roosters, and hens, clucking, cackling, and crowing, searching the barnyard throughout the long day like farm workers digging and hoeing. What are they looking for? What do they seek? Restlessly poking through gravel? Perhaps they want to dig up the past in prehistoric travel. Trying to bring back a T-Rex from that savage Jurassic country, they'd urge that fierce beast to return for a feast with Colonel Sanders as entree.
Look quick, they're running away across the African plain. Zebras, donkeys, eland, and gnu, like a herbivorous train. Don't get excited, stay in your seat. We'll capture each Jenny and Jack. The orchestra's all tuned up and ready to ride. We'll catch them and bring them right back.
The terms agoraphobia, fear of open spaces, That's why the tortoise brings his house when visiting new places. It makes the tortoise feel secure to have a place to hide. If someone makes him nervous, he'll just duck back inside. Safety is a blessing, but if you don't take chances, you'll seldom be invited to a cotillion's balls and dances. A tortoise can handle a ballad, slowly stepping through it, but if they play a can-can, just hear him try to do it.
In Hindustan, six blind men were known throughout the land for trying to describe an elephant using just their hand. One patted its side and called it a wall. The trunk was taken for a snake. Another thought its tusk a spear. The tail a rope. Another mistake. The fifth announced the ear was a fan. The sixth called its leg a tree. Now the bases will give their opinion. Tell me, what do you see?
Kangaroos go leaping through Australia's vast outback. With leap and bound, they cover ground alone or in a pack. Such energy, vitality, athletic without doubt. While you listen, they may wear you out.
Music. For plants, you will need an herbarium. For lizards and snakes, a terrarium. But if it's your wish to see tropical fish, you'll have to acquire an aquarium. That way, you can spy a shy octopi and a humuhumu nukunuku apua'a swimming by.
Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. One went left, the other right. At the junction, long I stood. Couldn't decide, try as I might. Whose woods these are, I think I know. A fellow who makes cuckoo clocks. The real bird puts on quite a show, making a sound that's heard for blocks. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep. The cuckoo's mournful cry goad, with miles to go before I sleep.
Thank you. The birds are a twitter. They flutter and flitter in huge cages called aviaries. There are hoopoes and petrels, toucans and kestrels, tanagers, doves, and canaries. Their avian greetings of chirpings and tweetings sound like a session of Congress to me. These chattering voices produce only noises. Let the orchestra make sense of this cacophony.
What's that noise in the music room? You hear the angry inquiries? Is it a kitten on the keys? A skateboard on the ivories? No, it's a piano student just starting to learn. She has to conquer the basic scales devised by Carl Czerny. It takes time and repetition. She knows the simple fact is the way to Carnegie Hall is to practice. Practice, practice.
Fossils. If you attend the museum, there you will see them, gigantic creatures who met a cruel fate, like Plesiosaurus and the huge Brontosaurus. After millions of years, they've lost much of their weight. Take care. Should you jostle a Jurassic fossil, it could collapse in a heap, bone on bone. How to restore it? Well, look in the score. It requires a first-class xylophone.
Thank you.
The swan, through mythology, ballet, and opera, glides the graceful swan. Also in this lovely music by Kamuela Philharmonic.
And so, at last, we've reached the finale, our symphonic trip's at an end. We've heard Saint-Saens' Carnival of the Animals, feathered, furried, and finned. This proves classical music's still the best. Tell your friends by phone or by text.